Today we want to quickly look at the chemistry practical experiments. So we have talked about three aspects of the experiments you are likely to have. So we said you are going to have the quantitative analysis and the qualitative analysis. So the third part of the question will be a general question. So everybody should listen to me. So the third part will be a general question. The first part is quantitative analysis, where you are going to be carrying out titration in order to know probably the concentration of a particular solution. One of them, I told you them, will be given. That one that will be given is called a standard solution. A standard solution is a solution that you know the concentration. So this base has actually been prepared by dissolving a particular mass of the base has been dissolved in water. So from there we can calculate the concentration of the base. Now for this one, now we don't really know the concentration. From the titration, we will know a particular volume of this acid that will exactly neutralize a particular volume of the base. I hope you're getting that. So when we know the volume of the base, we know the volume of the acid, we already know the concentration of the base. That means we can calculate the concentration of the what? Of the acid. You understand? So this is a known, this is unknown. So we use the known to calculate the unknown in this experiment. So we'll be carrying out this titration in order to know the volume of the acid that will exactly neutralize a particular volume of the base at what you call the equivalence point or the end point. At the end point, we are going to see a color change. Our indicator for this experiment is methyl orange. And I want to believe you all know why we're using methyl orange. Number one, we have a strong acid and a strong base. And for a strong acid and a strong base, what type of indicators do we use? Any suitable indicator. You understand? Any suitable, as long as it is a strong acid or a strong base, we use any suitable indicator. So with what we have here now, we have been asked to use methyl orange. So you are going to see a color change when the experiment starts. I told you how to determine the color change when we're having acid-base class normally. So, but from this experiment, you see the color for this is actually like orange. Then you see a particular color change. So when the color changes, then you stop the experiment. So at that point where you are seeing the color change, we call it the end point. And you tabulate your reading. How many of you still remember that we tabulate our reading? I said it that, number one, you must write the volume of pipettes that we are going to use. So in different laboratory, it depends. The volume of the pipettes we are using is 25. So if you check it very well, it is 25. Now, this is called the pipettes. I know many of you should have been used to this. This is called the what? Burette. This is burette. So this is the pipette. What do you call this flask? Conical flask. So this is a beaker. So you use your beaker to hold volume of a particular acid or base. Then this is the conical flask, where the reaction will take place itself. So in this pipette that I'm using now, some schools might use 20. So you can't use their own 20 to do your own calculation. Whatever you use for your experiment is what will be involved in your calculation. We are using a 25 mil pipette. So this 25 mil pipette is what you will write here. So you say that the volume of the pipette used, you write it on top of your table. That's 25 cm cube. Then what indicator are you using? So you write indicator used. That is what? Methyl orange. So you used methyl orange. Now, when you want to tabulate your table, how do you have it? We said you are going to have a part that is showing the burette reading. Abby? So you have the burette reading, and you leave your burette reading in centimeter cube, right? Then you have rough. That is the one to just first run through your experiment and see how it will go. So you have the rough. You have which one again? So you have your force titer or force titration. Then you have your second. You can write it in full like second. Like second. But if you write first here, so you write second here. Second titration. Do you understand that? Then you write your, depending on the number of experiments you want to carry out. So that is your third titration. Now, from your table, always use your ruler so that you get a neat table when you are drawing your table. Now, from your table, we're going to have, I hope you know that your table carries a lot of mark. So we'll have our final burette reading. Final burette reading. Since centimeter cube is here, you don't have to put it, but to be on the safer side, so you put it. Is that taken? So the volume, final burette reading, then that is what you're going to have. So you're definitely going to have final burette reading for the experiment, but your initial burette reading, final burette reading is when you're trying to take your reading and you are pipetting, you're allowing the liquid to fall, to drop into the conical flask. The volume will drop to a particular level. That level where it drops is your final reading. So your initial reading is that level you are starting from, and most likely we will all start from zero. When it gets to final burette reading, you can refill it or you continue. This burette reading is 15 mil. That's the calibration for this burette. So our final burette reading, then we're going to have the initial burette reading. I hope you're following that. So the unit will also be what? Centimeter cube. Then what will be here? What will you have here? Volume of acid used. Those of you that have read, you will understand what we're saying. So we've done this table before we start the experiment. So you write your volume of acid used. So the volume of acid used also in centimeter cube. So that's what you have for your table of experiments. Now, with this now, you can carry out your experiment. So the first thing we want to check is the rough. We are going to fill the burette. What do we fill into the burette? The acid. So we fill the acid into the burette. Then when we fill the acid into the burette, we pipette the base. A 25 ml of the base. We pipette it into the conical flask. But we'll first pour the base here so that we take easily a 25 ml. Now, instead of you using your mouth, this is what we call pipette filler. So the pipette filler helps you, instead of all those things you used to do that quickly remove it. And many of you would have allowed your spit or something. And some of you might even suck up the liquid, which is not hygienic enough. So that's why we're using the pipette filler. So you take 25 ml of the base. This is the base, sodium hydroxide. And this is just to hold the acid as well, HCl. It's a diluted acid, but be careful with chemicals when you are using them. So we want to start our experiments now. When we're starting, let's have our acid. And don't forget, from what I told you, you must rinse your burette with the acid. So this is the acid. So first thing you want to do is try and rinse your burette with the acid. So that's the first precaution. You can rinse your burette with the acid. Then when you are through with that, normally you use water, distilled water. Let me to pass distilled water there. You use distilled water to rinse your conical flask before you put your base. You don't use the base to rinse the conical flask. That is another thing. So that you don't increase the volume too much. So you use your distilled water to rinse the flask. That's the conical flask. I will leave you to this experiment, so you all will try your own experiment as well. So pay attention closely. So, rinsing the conical flask. So I have it, trying to air dry. Now, I've rinsed my burettes and I've rinsed my conical flask. Now, you fill the acid to the brim, to zero, not to the brim per se, to the zero mark. You can see it here. So to this zero mark, you avoid error due to parallax too. When you are taking your reading, we said it. You don't look from here, and you don't look from here. So you can adjust it to your height, but I don't know. So people like Dorcas now and Benedicta, but try. If you are not too tall, you can get it too. But don't worry. You can reduce the height of this to your own height, or you linger to just make sure you look at it directly. So that's what you do. Now let's fill our acid with the, I've told you two precautions now. First is you rinse your burette with what? The acid. Second is you rinse your conical flask with what? Distilled water. So now let's fill the burette with the acid. Up to the zero. So, with what we have is more than zero, so let's just take it back to zero, it's allowed. So it dropped little by little. So you look at the base of the meniscus, so it's already at zero mark. So, which means that the first thing you do is that you record. We have it at zero mark, and you leave the answer in how many decimal places? Two decimal places. So our initial correct reading is 0.00. Do you understand that?
Yes,
so that's our initial correct reading. Then let's pipette the base. Now, in pipetting the base, don't forget, that's why we have to label this, even though it's going off. Don't worry, I have it here, so that I don't make mistake. So that's our acid, that's our HCl. So let's intro. You can see we're only using the beaker to hold the liquid. So we have our base here. So now, what is the mean? What is the mean of this thing? 25. So we want to bring in 25 mean. So you use your filler, you dip it inside. Now, the function of this filler is that they are air trapped. Many of you that understand physics, air is trapped in this tube. Air is trapped. So if you dip in this, liquid can't just come up. So you have to use this filler to get out the air, because there's air pressure on the surface of the liquid too that will make the liquid to rise off the tube. But now you allow the air to go out by, you can see, you hold this upper part, so you press. Before you release this one, you release the upper part so that it remains like this. The air is out. Then, now, air is out. You now press this. This one helps you to bring up the liquid. This one helps you to dispense the liquid. So, you press this. You can see the liquid is coming up. Then there is this mark. You can see that the liquid has stopped coming. Okay, it's still coming up. There's a particular mark here. Can you see the mark?
Yes, sir.
That mark is where the 25 mil is at. Do you understand that? So now it has gone beyond that mark. So what do? I press the one to allow it to go out. Can you see that the liquid is falling? So let me come to your right. So gently, 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 gently. So avoid error due to. So that is, this is 25 ml of the base, and you drop it in the conical flask, so you dispense it. This is still our rough. So that is that. We have 25 ml of the base already. Then what do we do next? We add our indicator. This is our indicator and it's methyl orange. 2 drops of the indicator is enough. So you drop 2 drops of the indicator. So check it out. 1, 2. So 2 drops is enough. Now you can see the color change there. Now you release your acid. For the reaction to mix properly, you have to continue to shake while you are carrying out the titration. So I release the acid. At the point where you are going to be seeing color change, you stop releasing the acid. You see that it's almost changing color slightly, so you gently release it, drop by drop, while you continue to shake properly, drop by drop. Can you see now that we have a color change that is different from what we started with? Now if you look at what we have here, this paper is here in order for us to see the color clearly. Do you understand that? So now we have a color change and we will now take our final reading. So let's look at it together. This is, that's, can you see, that's 36.5, if you look at it very well. So avoid error due to parallax. So this is 36.5. You know, we have 36.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, and so on, because you have 10 lines in between. So that's 36.50. So that is our rough. That's our rough. Now, what we started with is 0.00. So, which means our final reading now, this minus this will give us our final reading, 36.50. So, what you dispose this. So, you can, where is the distilled water? So let's check it out again. So our first reading now. So let's introduce, you can start your initial reading from 36.5, but since this is 36.5, which means next reading might go to 60 something. You understand? If you start from 36.5. So if it's going to 60 something, that means it will fall below 50. You know, it ends at 50. So you have to refill it. So you refill the acid. Then another mistake you should not make is that when you are done filling your acid, like you fill the acid, so please be careful about that as well. When you are done filling the acid to the zero mark, so when you fill the acid and it's already at the zero mark, so it's at the zero mark, make sure, please don't forget, make sure you do what? Remove this. You can see that when I was about to remove this, some liquid had to drop. So make sure you remove this. So that liquid that dropped now would have added to the volume already. and that's a significant error. So that's why you always do rub first, so that even if there's any error by chance, you can get rid of that error. So now we want to start our proper titration. Don't forget to always remove what this funnel from it. That is another precaution you also have to take notes. Is that taken? So now let's pipette 25 mil. Can any one of you try and pipette the 25 mil for us from the base? Or I should continue to do that. Let me do one more in your presence. So this is the base. So I'm letting the air out. So the air is out already. Then you can hold this for the liquid to come up to the 25 mil mark. So gently drop it. So it is at zero now. Is that okay? At the 25 mark now. So you drop the liquid. So you'll be allowed to perform your own experiments individually now. And you write your paper on the board. So that's what we have. 25 mil. Be careful with the glasses. So what do we do now? 2 drops of the methyl orange. Introduce your acid. Don't forget, we have returned it to what? Zero mark. So which means our initial breath reading will be what? 0.00. Since we're starting from zero mark. So now you introduce your acid gently. Introduce it until you're about to see the color change. Continue to shake for proper reaction. Any acid that is added at the end of the reaction will not react. So that's why you have to be careful. So when you're about to notice the color change, then you drop it drop by drop. Don't be nervous. The moment you are noticing the color change, you can see that it's coming up. Just drop by drop, see everything changing. So now there's a color change. So what is the reading? You can see that the reading is even like 36.2 or 36.1. Where's 36? This 37. Okay, that's 36 there. So that's 36.6 or 36.7. Look at the base of the meniscus. Can you see that? That's 35, 36. So it's 36. So that's 36.00. Although any error you're having must not be more than plus or minus 1.00 or plus or minus 0.10 or 0.20. So whatever error you have in the difference, look at the gap here now. It's almost like 0.5, Abby. So let's go on with this. Now what we have here is what? 36.00. Is that taken? So let's go for the next one. So which means that at every time we have to always refill So we introduce what now? Our base now. And how many mil?
25
mil. So you hold this part, you press it, you press this part, so you are letting what? The air out. Then you release this part, then you release this. Do you get that? So you now press this for the liquid to come. So, with what we have now, we dispense. So, errors in all these things can lead to variations. So, yes. The bubbles is because I had to first press. So by pressing it, the air in this place blows down. You understand? It goes down and it's just like you putting your head inside water and blowing air. What do you notice? The bubbles come up. The liquid is denser than the air you are blowing. So the gas has to come up while the liquid goes down. You understand that? So, then let's refill our acid in the burette. Let's just do it. So we have, we're going back to the zero mark. So. Consider any time we want to remove the funnel, some liquid they have to drop and so we are at the zero mark now. Is that okay? So what do we do? Introduce our one. This should just be two drops. Don't try and be varying whatever you're doing. You don't use two drops for the previous one, you now use three for the second one. You're introducing too much errors. So, we go on. So we have the color change. So now it's the same value, 36.5. It's 36.5. So where did we start from? Our initial red reading, that's what? 0.00. So we now have 36.50. Is that taken? Let's do the last one. Okay. So, we rinse again. The other one, was it on 36 or 36.6? It was 36.6. So please, pay attention to this thing. The one we saw, because I knew the difference is like 0.2. One. So this one was what? 36.6. Is that taken? That was what we saw the first time. 36.6, not 36. So now we have just rinsed that. Then we introduce our base again for the final part. So we are in Nigeria. can see that it's not coming up again. Why do you think it's not coming up? We still have air trapped here. So the air trapped is pushing against the liquid, while atmospheric pressure is pushing against this one. So they are now balanced. So you let the air out again, so that you reduce the pressure there. So now that NEPA have taken our light, I hope you can still see. So that's 25. Thank God we have good eyes. Maybe God knows what Nigeria would have turned us to. So you dispense the liquid. So you can see what we are facing now. In case you become the president, and you promise us change. So, let your change be positive. Shake it. Is that one?
Is that it? So.
Okay. Yes. You know, we are getting it. So now, let's refill the acid. Zero. Don't be scared. When you take chemicals from reagent bottles, you don't return the chemicals inside the reagent bottle after you've dispensed what you want. You don't return it. I'll show you all the chemicals, their reagent bottles later. Can you see? We are at the meniscus now. That's zero now. So, someone else to check. That's 36.5, Abby. So you can see that the difference is not that much. So this was our final reading. That's 36.50. So this is also 36.50. And we started from 0.00. So the final volume will be 36.50. I hope you understand that. So now, if you look at what we have here, you see that almost everything is the same. That means we really didn't have much errors in our experiments. The difference is just like 0.1. You understand that? That's like the difference. So what do we do next now that we have gotten this? We'll calculate the average titer value. And how do you do that? So your average titer value will give you what? You can add the three titrations together. So that will be your first titration plus the second titration plus the third titration all over three. So what is the first titration? 36.60 plus, so someone should do that for us, 36.50 plus 36.50 all over 3. So what do we have all together? 36.53. Are you sure? You add these 3 together and you divide by 3. So 36.53 centimeter cubed. So this is the volume of acid used. And our acid involved what? HCl and NaOH. So, NaOH. Some basic calculations will be involved here, so we might do that in the next class. So, we are going to have our NaCl, right? And don't forget, this is aqueous, solid being dissolved in water. This is also aqueous. Why this will be solid plus what is it called? H2O. But you know your solid sodium hydroxide, I mean sodium chloride will also dissolve in the water. H2O. So that's the equation for the reaction. Now for this equation, the ratio is 1:1:1:1. So now you know the volume of the base. What is the volume of the base? 25 cm³. Do you understand that? Now, what is the volume of the acid? That is 36.53. So we don't know the concentration of the acid. We'll calculate that, but we'll be supplied the concentration of the base from our question. So I'll give you a question, I will try different set of calculations on everything. So when you know the concentration of the base, you use our what? CA, VA over CB, VB equals NA over NB. So very good. Then you calculate. So any other additional questions they had, you try and solve them using your stoichiometry. You understand that? So basic stoichiometric IQ to solve the rest, and you've practiced enough questions on stoichiometry. So do you have any questions before you start yours? These are the ones we are going to use for the salt analysis. So if you look at this now, we have our test tube, we still have our ammonia solution, we have K2Cr2O7, we have hydrated copper sulfate. We said that all sulfates are soluble except barium, lead, sulfate, and so on. Then ammonium carbonate, which I said all sorts of ammonia are also what? Water soluble. So we're going to be carrying out salt analysis on this in the next class. So you keep that in mind. But before we go, is there any question? And if there's no question, we're going to have two persons. Maybe we should run generator so that you people can have light to run your own experiment. So the two of you, one boy and a girl, so you run it. Why the rest? Let me start from rinsing it for you. So you use this for you people can hold the base together in the same flask. So this might not be needed. Why you have your own funnel. So you can just keep it here. So you drop your funnel there. Let me dispense the base. Don't be scared. Just undo it and don't break bottles. So don't be scared. It's normal thing that we've been doing. So this is the funnel for you. Don't forget, if I see you make any error, I will deduct your mark. And I will write to WAEC that the students are making errors. So try and get used to it, to understand. Don't mind you, I won't write to WAEC. I don't know who is going to mark your results. Before your parents will come and meet me later, that one that made that student mistake. So, but I know you will not fail. You people are intelligent individuals. So, carry out your experiment. This is the acid. Let me dispense the acid. Do not use your hand to clean up the base and you now carry base for acid. So, when you need the acid, you carry it with you. When you need the base, you carry it. When it's almost getting over, you refill. So that's that. So let's keep them on this side so that anytime you need them, you have the labeling on them. So.